Hello, my name is Vaughan Callan, and I'd like to welcome you to ESD Basics Bitesize, brought to you by Desco Europe. And during our series of Bitesize videos, we will be introducing to you what static electricity is, the harmful effects of static electricity, and how in the high-tech manufacturing environment we can overcome the harmful effects of ESD. And in today's part one, we'll be looking at what is static electricity and what is ESD. Let's start by looking at static electricity, or it can also be called electrostatic charge. So the first thing to note is that all materials will tribocharge. Now, electrostatic charge generation occurs when two surfaces in contact then separate. Some atom electrons transfer, causing an imbalance. One surface has positive charge polarity and one surface has negative charge polarity. Both polarity charges need to be controlled in your ESD control program. Both positive and negative charges can discharge and damage electronic components. A static field meter can be used to measure the charge of a field, and after contact and separation show that one item will be negatively charged, having an excess of electrons. The other item will be positively charged, having lost some electrons. For most people, static electricity is represented by the noise or crackle heard on a radio that interferes with good reception, or the shock experience when touching a metal object after walking across a carpeted room or sliding across a car seat. Static electricity is also observed as static cling when clothes are stuck together after coming out of a clothes dryer. Most of the time, people observe static electricity when the weather is cold and dry. While many people tend to think of static electricity as being at rest or not moving, static electricity causes the most concern when it ceases to be stationary. Electrostatic charge is most commonly formed by the contact and separation of two materials. The materials may be similar or dissimilar, although dissimilar materials tend to liberate higher levels of static charge. An example is a person walking across the floor. Static electricity is produced when the person's shoe sole makes contact, then separates from the floor surface. Another example is an electronic device sliding in or out of a bag, a magazine, or a tube. So having identified some very simple everyday activities that can generate static electricity, what I'm going to do now is just give you some practical demonstrations of that. And what I'm going to be using is our digital field meter. And if you look at it from your left to right, the first number would represent thousands of volts, then hundreds of volts, and then tens of volts. And what we were talking about before was the voltage that can be generated by simply opening a regular plastic bag. So what I've got here is a normal polythene bag. And what I'll do, I'm just going to pick it up off the surface, open it up for being folded. Then we can see there's over 600 volts generated on that. So very simple to generate significant voltage. Another example I gave earlier on was unwinding regular tape. Once again, if I take some tape and I just pull that and hold it over the sensor, there we can see again voltage in excess of 1,000 volts. And a final demonstration just for you. I'll just move my chair out of the way. And what I'm going to simply do is hold my hand over the meter and just move around and see what sort of voltage levels that we're going to generate. So I'm holding my hand over the meter, and if I just gently scuff my feet, I can see, again, voltages approaching and just exceeding 1,000 volts. So that's how easy it is to generate static electricity.
ESD, or electrostatic discharge, is the rapid, spontaneous transfer of electrostatic charge induced by a high electrostatic field. Usually, the charge flows through a spark between two bodies at different electrostatic potentials as they approach one another. If two items are at different electrostatic charge levels as they approach one another, a spark or electrostatic discharge can occur. This rapid, spontaneous transfer of electrostatic charge can generate heat and melt circuitry in electronic components. In a normal environment like your home, there are innumerable ESD events occurring, most of which you do not see or feel. It takes a discharge greater than 2,000 volts for a person to feel the discharge. ESD is the hidden enemy in a high-tech manufacturing environment.
Just because you cannot see or feel an ESD event, it does not mean that ESD events are not occurring. Human beings are insensitive unless the ESD is somewhat above 2000 volts. Many electronic components can be damaged by much smaller discharges. There is no exact voltage number where a person starts to feel a discharge, although, as we've said, is somewhat above 2000 volts. ESD control is necessary to prevent innumerable little lightning bolts or ESD events from occurring. 25% of unidentified electronic failures are typically a result of ESD. Here we have a photo of ESD arcing from a person's finger to a component. This is not a computer simulation, although the technician was connected to a small magneto to enable us to take the photograph of the ESD arcing from his finger to the component, as you can see here, manifesting itself in that small lightning bolt. This is that same component we saw in the previous slide, although we've taken a photograph on a Scannon electron micrograph. The image is of the ESD damage after the removal of the capacitor metallization. Note the characteristic eruption through the oxide, and to get this photograph, it was magnified 10,500 times.